on CBS 46, shocking attempts to skirt COVID mandates. Thousands of fake vaccine cards seized by federal agents in recent months.
And tonight, our CBS 46 investigative team crosses state lines to get an exclusive firsthand look at the illegal counterfeit shipments, many of them headed right here to Atlanta.
It comes as we approach a November 22nd federal vaccine mandate. That's a deadline impacting as many as 100 million American workers. Our Crystal Bowie has more on the story.
Sean and Rick, let's say you're one of those people that is required to get the vaccine, but you don't want to. A vaccine like this one, a vaccine card like this one, is something that is in such high demand that federal agents are calling it a hot commodity.
378 miles north of Atlanta is where U.S. Customs and Border Protection officers work around the clock to stop illegal contraband from getting into Georgia.
There's a lot more narcotics.
The agents in Memphis, Tennessee find MDMA, known as ecstasy, cocaine, and fentanyl nonstop.
We enforce over 400 laws for 40 different agencies.
But now they have a new challenge on their hands.
We've seized roughly 1,000 shipments.
Shipments of cards.
Each containing anywhere from 5 to 100 cards.
The 18-year veteran is talking about hundreds of counterfeit COVID-19 vaccine cards infiltrating the states from foreign countries.
This all started over the summer when officers were looking for counterfeit driver's licenses, and then they found counterfeit vaccine cards.
We're in the tough stretch.
In September.
This is a pandemic of the unvaccinated.
The Biden administration announced a COVID-19 vaccination mandate.
What our objective is from the federal government is to continue to take bold and ambitious steps to get more people vaccinated and protect more people.
At least 14,788 fake vaccine cards have come into the United States through Memphis since the mandate was announced. Of those, 7 shipments originally heading to Georgia.
They seem to be a hot commodity right now.
So how believable are these cards?
We all tossed it around, looked at it, and upon a closer look, the high gloss paper, the misspellings and the grammatical errors are what led us to determine that they were counterfeit.
Authorities say it could be difficult to pursue any legal action with businesses in other countries supplying them. But buying, selling, or using counterfeit vaccine cards is a crime. It can be categorized as unauthorized use of an official government agency seal, fraud, or theft.
I know people have their stance on it. My stance is it's a violation of federal law.
Our Crystal Bowie joins us live now. And Crystal, why is it important to confiscate these fake vaccine cards?
Well, it is illegal to have a fake vaccine card, but it is also a public health problem. Let's say you don't have a real card and you're pretending you do. You could get into schools, businesses, say go into work pretending that you're vaccinated and you're not. And then instead, you could be putting other people, including yourself, at risk of the deadly virus. Sean.
Crystal Bowie live for us. Crystal, thank you. Happening.